Hey everybody, welcome back to Biblical Seekers. Today, we're going to see if it's okay to attend a Sunday-keeping church and keep the seventh-day Sabbath. It's time to seek the truth.
Then I saw an angel coming down from heaven, holding in his hand the key to the bottomless pit and a great chain. And he seized the dragon, that ancient serpent, and bound him for 1,000 years, and threw him into the pit and shut it and sealed it over him, that he might not deceive the nations any longer. The wicked plots against the just, and they gnash their teeth upon the just people. My loins are filled with a loathsome disease, knowing you have committed such a sin. And from now on, you're cursed from the earth. Dust to dust, ashes to ashes. Now remember, all come from dust. To dust all shall return.
Okay, let's get started. You see, we can worship God every day. As a matter of fact, the saints of God serve our Lord continually in all that they do. However, we cannot blindly go and attend a church service that is misleading the flock and that trample on the very commandments of God and twist scripture to justify their way. You see, we are not to join them. We cannot be fornicating with these churches, but rather we are to warn them, teaching every man in all wisdom, as it says in Colossians chapter 1, verse 28. Whom we preach, warning every man, and teaching every man in all wisdom, that we may present every man perfect in Christ Jesus. So we are to warn every man and stand for the truth, even if it means we stand alone. We are to sound the trumpet, and these churches may look godly from appearance, but we must take heed not to marvel at these false apostles, who look like ministers of righteousness, because even Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light, yet is full of deceitfulness. Here, let's take a look at 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 13 through 15. For such are false apostles, deceitful workers, transforming themselves into the apostles of Christ. And no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. Therefore, it is no great thing if his ministers also be transformed as the ministers of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works. You see, Satan tried to mislead and deceive Jesus too, but he always responded, "For it is written." And in the same way, we ought to walk even as he walked, as it says in 1 John chapter 2, verse 6. He that saith he abideth in him ought himself also to walk even as he walked. And we are to fight our battles in the same manner, for it is written, the Sabbath is the seventh day, and we are not to join those who trample the very word of God. And Jesus even warns us in the end times, do not be deceived. Here, let's have a look at Matthew chapter 24, verses 3 and 4. And as he sat upon the Mount of Olives, the disciples came unto him privately, saying, tell us, when shall these things be? And what shall be the sign of thy coming, and of the end of the world? And Jesus answered and said unto them, take heed that no man deceive you. But you see, we are to take heed, as Jesus said, that no man deceives us, and not blindly follow the blind, without searching the scriptures daily, to see whether these things be so, as we can see in Acts chapter 17, verse 11. These were more noble than those in Thessalonica, in that they received the word with all readiness of mind, and searched the scriptures daily, whether those things were so. So when we see others in error, even if it's a whole ministry or organization, we are to correct them with biblical truth. We cannot join them hand in hand and partake in their sins of breaking the very law of God, or their blood will be required at your hands. It is so important that we stand for biblical truth, especially in the end times. When deception is at an all-time high, we as believers should come out of these churches, especially when we see them in error, and when they're not willing to change their ways. Here, let's see what God says in Revelation chapter 18, verse 4. And I heard another voice from heaven, saying, come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plagues. You see, there will be two brides, one married to Christ, and the other will be married to the one who looks like Christ, but is fake. One bride follows the word of God, and is watching for his appearing. This is the church married to the Lamb, and is willing to follow him anywhere he leads, even into suffering or even death. But the harlot bride, on the other hand, knows about the Lamb, but is not willing wholeheartedly to give up the world and the attractions in it, and they see nothing wrong with it. Yet we are to awaken to righteousness and sin not, as we can see in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 34. Awake to righteousness and sin not, for some have not the knowledge of God. I speak this to your shame. You see, even with the burnt offering Cain and Abel offered to God, Abel offered exactly what God asked for, but Cain tried offering vegetables. His offering and worship was rejected by God. You see, there's a way that may seem right unto man, but only leads to death, as it says in Proverbs chapter 14, verse 12. There is a way which seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death. So just because it seems right, doesn't make it right. And just because it feels right, doesn't make it right either. If you choose to obey God, then you obey him in all things. We are to be a good soldier of Jesus Christ, and we are to hearken careful to his commandments, and to follow and obey them sincerely from our heart. For it is the very love of God that we keep his commandments, as we can see in 1 John chapter 5, verse 3. For this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not grievous. You see, the Ten Commandments has never changed, and never will change, because the law of God is a part of God, and he does not change. So if you deny the Sabbath, then you're denying Jesus, because he is Lord of the Sabbath. Here, let's take a look at the Catholic records. Sunday is founded, not of scripture, but on tradition, and is distinctly a Catholic institution, as there is no scripture for the transfer of the day of rest from the last to the first day of the week. Protestants ought to keep their Sabbath on Saturday, and thus leave Catholics in full possession of Sunday. So you see, there is no way we should follow after the doctrines of another church, whether it be Catholics, Baptists, Pentecostals, Mormons, Jehovah's Witness, and so on. We should live solely on what the scripture says. We cannot be found lukewarm in these end times. Choose this day whom you will serve. But as for me and my house, we shall serve the Lord.